Mick is a documentary filmmaker. When we first meet Mick, he has his camera trained on Jimmy, who he's been following without Jimmy's knowledge, as Jimmy guts and kills this prostitute, takes out her eyeballs, and puts them in baby food jars. Crazy! Jimmy sees Mick and his camera and tries to catch and kill him, but Mick gets away. But Mick has an idea. Blackmail the serial killer into allowing him to film the serial killer and his life for his movie. Did I mention that Mick used to be an alcoholic drug addict? There you go. There you go. In The Perfect Witness from First Look International Pictures.
It was him. A serial killer.
I filmed him kill somebody.
What are you gonna do? Mick, what are you gonna do?
Meet him.
So what do you want from me?
I want to do this documentary.
What if I decide my next victim is you?
Nobody's ever done what I'm doing, Gino.
I know it was you.
I still got those tapes.
Guess what I got?
Did you ever hear your mother scream?
Get the camera.
Jimmy, please.
You could have taken that tape to the police. And if you did, none of this would be happening.
You got to ask yourself if you still want to find the human behind the monster.
This movie here is yet another fine example of why less can be more, my friends. Think about all those fancy torture, horror, Saw-type movies with their slick looks and over-the-top violence, and then throw that garbage out the window and bring it back down to the basics. One angry dude doing some really bad things. We get to spend a lot of quality time with Jimmy, and it's not pleasant time because Jimmy is flat out of his freaking mind. Now, this isn't a movie that is filled with a lot of violence, but when it does get violent, this violence has impact because it is brutal and mighty unsettling. Everything that happens in this fine film is important, so pay attention, because The Perfect Witness, despite its terrible title, is lean, mean, and very unsettling. It's not perfect. The character of Mick could very well be the dumbest character in the history of the planet Earth. I know he's a recovering drug addict and all, and I know you can only blame crack for so much stupid behavior. Then as stupid as Mick was for most of the movie, all of a sudden, he makes Sherlock Holmes look like an idiot. A bit inconsistent there. But we're gonna let that slide because the rest of this movie was so good. The Perfect Witness. One twist.